Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today in this video we will see what is earned value analysis and how do we do that in Oracle Primavera P6. So first of all, let us know few things about earned value analysis. So earned value analysis, or EVA, is nothing but analyzing the project performance about the cost and time for a particular project. So when I say project performance about cost, it means we have already planned to spend some money for our project. It doesn't have to be the same when we finish the project. So we might have spent more money or less money. So that is what the project performance about cost. And when it comes to time, project performance about time, it means it is about how much time we are taking, whether more time or less time than what we had planned. We might have planned the project to finish within 50 days, but we may take 60 days, which means the project got delayed. At the same time, we may take 40 days, which means we have finished the project earlier. So that is what project performance about time or schedule. So this is what basically earned value means. So we will see in the software using a simple example. So I'll open a simple problem to make you understand what is EVA. So this is our problem. Let me explain you what it is. Just look at it. So we basically have an activity. An activity A, which is of 10 days. Which is of 10 days. We have planned to spend 1000 rupees for this project. We have planned to spend 1000 rupees for this project. Each day 100 rupees, for 10 days it will be 1000 rupees. Get it right? We have an activity of 10 days and we have planned to spend 1000 rupees each day 100. And when you look at it, you can easily understand that each day we are going to finish 10% of work. So each day 10% of work, if we do at the end of 10th day, we'll be finishing 100% of work. Right? But according to the field report that I got during this project completion, at the end of 7th day, at the end of 7th day, I have finished only 50% of work. Got it? At the end of 7th day, I actually should have finished 70% of work. Right? Our plan was to finish 10% of work each day. So at the end of 7th day, it should have been 70%. But when we are on the project, we have finished only 50% of work at the end of 7th day. And we have spent 900 rupees out of this 1000 rupees. How much we should have actually taken from that? I mean, how much we should have spent? We should have spent 700 rupees, right? Each day 10% of work and each day 100 rupees we need to take according to our plan. But when we started the project, due to some reason, we were able to finish only 50% of work at the end of 7th day, which should have been 70%, and we have spent 900 rupees instead of 700 rupees. So this is the problem. So this is the problem. So now let us get the same scenario in the software. So I'll go to the software. Under the mechanical EPS, I'll create a new project. Click on next. Some random project ID and project name. Click on next. Project plan started going to be 30 March 9 a.m. Select next, 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 finish. So we have our project here. Let us assign a calendar. Go to default, go to calendar, select a calendar. Now open the project. Now we are on the activities window. Let us add an activity A. In case if you see any baseline bars like this, just right click here, go to bars, switch it off. Because what you see there is not the proper baseline. We will have to create it later. We'll have to create it later. So let us come back to the topic. So we have added an activity A. Let us change its duration to 10 days. Now let us go to enterprise resource. I'll add a new resource naming PM for project manager, and let us assign the same calendar as that of the project. It is same here, FIDATAR. I used FIDATAR for the project, so for the resource also I'm going with the same calendar. So now come to the units and prices and change the standard rate to 100 per day. We are I told you in the problem per day we are spending 100 rupees. In the software it is dollar, just imagine that is rupees, or just imagine it rupees. So 100 per day. Come to the activities window. Now let us assign the resource to this activity, project manager. So for the activity A, I have assigned project manager per day 1 for 10 days, 10 units. So for 10 days, say BAC, this is BAC, 1000. I wanted the BAC to be 1000 and I have it here, BAC. For 10 days, 1000 we are going to spend. So this is what we are planning. Okay. Now the next thing is, yeah, you need to assign baseline. So go to project, maintain baseline, click on add, save a copy, OK, change its name to whatever you want. Here, initial planning baseline, save and close. Now again go to project, assign baseline. Now in the project baseline, select the newly created baseline here, and even in the primary, select the baseline that we created just now. Click on OK. Now right click here, go to bars. Now switch on the primary baseline and apply. Okay. So this is the way of creating baseline. So as I told you already, if at all you see the baseline before you start a project, just go to bars and uncheck this. We have to check this only after these two procedures. So now let us go to the updation part. I want to have this scenario at the end of 7th day. I have finished only 50% of work by spending 900 rupees, which should have been 70% by spending 700 rupees as per the plan. This is actually what is happening, and this is what we had planned. Got it? So this is past and this is the present. Okay, let us go to the software. So go select the highlight the activity. Now go to status. So you can see here in the status, The activity is starting 30 March 9 a.m. and it is getting finished on 10th 6 p.m. Since it is a 10-day activity, it is taking 10 days here, according to our plan. But the scenario here is we have finished only 50% by spending 900 rupees. So let us see how do we get that scenario. So go to the activity, make it started. We have finished only 50% of work at the end of 7th day. So when it will be starting from March 30, when will be the 7th day that you need to enter in the schedule here. So 30, 31, 1, 2, 3, 5 days finished. So if it was as per the plan, 3 will be selecting because per day 10%. So for 50%, we need to consider 5 days, right? But in the problem, we need to get at the end of 7th day, we are finishing 50%. So 2 days, 2 days delay. 2 days delay you need to consider. So fourth you can't add, fifth you can't add because they are non-working days. Now come to sixth and seventh. At the end of 7th day, we are finishing 50% of work. The activity is starting on 30 March and it is getting finished 50% on the 7th day. So select 7 here and make it 6 p.m. Select schedule. So now what you need to do is labor cost you need to enter. We have spent 900 rupees for the 50% of work. So just enter 900 here. It is not taking because there is a small bug in the software. Just close the software and open it again. It will be okay. Maybe in the latest update, it might be okay now. The bug might have been removed. So come to the actual here and enter 900. So can you see? Can you see here? It got updated. Actual total cost, we have already spent 900 out of the 1000 that we plan to spend. And look at the schedule and activity percent complete. We should have finished 70% at this point, right? At this point, we should have finished 70% of work, but we were able to finish only 50% of work by spending 900 rupees. Now we have the same scenario here. We should have finished 70% of work, but we have finished only 50% of work. We should have spent, okay, 1000 we plan to spend for the entire project, but we have spent 900 rupees already out of this 1000 rupees. So earned value cost is nothing but it says how much money you should have spent for the date that you see here. Or you can take it that way, this way also. Earned value cost is nothing but for the activity percentage complete, how much money you should have spent according to your project plan. So on this day we have finished only 50% of work. So for the 50% of work, for the 50% of work, how much money we should have spent? We plan to spend 100 per day. For 50% of work, we are going to spend 500 rupees. So that is what this earned value here is. Got it? It comes automatically. For the 50% of work, we should have actually spent 500 rupees. So this is the basic thing about earned value cost, but But we have some more things to know about earned value, which I will show you in the next video. That is about forecasting and tracking. So first comes the tracking, then forecasting. So we will see that in the next video. I will be continuing with the same problem. Please go check it out. If you have any doubts, please comment below. And if you want to get daily updates on my YouTube channel, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.